I hope everybody's out there doing well today. I just wanted to talk to you real quick about a situation that I had to make some adjustments for on the water this past weekend when I was out fishing. So in my area in Wyoming and even through Colorado and our region, flows are really low, lower than they even normally would be this time of year. And so this piece of water that I was on, I've had great success in the past streamer fishing. Now a typical setup and what I planned to use was a heavier shooting head line, nice fast sink rate, with a shorter leader and a larger double articulated streamer. There's plenty of large fish in there that'll pursue that, eat that type of pattern. But when I showed up, the flow levels were extremely low, lower than anything I'd seen. So still wanting to throw streamers, I just had to adjust and change up what I was doing. And that's kind of what I wanted to speak to today, was just shallow or low flow options for streamers. So instead of the sinking line, I used a floating line that I rigged up with. Off of that, I rigged up and I used my Mass Bandit. You can see these on my website, Vitalian Videos for them. They're a super simple tie, but they're light. There's no weight on this guy. And so the combo of that floating line and this light unweighted streamer allows me to target areas and strip through areas that I wouldn't be able to do with a larger streamer. I also went with a much longer leader. The flows are really clear, they're really low on this piece of water, and these fish are fairly spooky. And so I was fishing about a 12 to a 12 and a half foot leader to this single unweighted Mass Bandit. So there's still little buckets, little bends and troughs and cut banks that those bigger fish are holding in. But as soon as you transition out of those areas, it gets really shallow, anywhere from like a foot to 6 inches. And so what this setup allowed me to do, it still allowed me to work and to target those buckets and bends with my presentation, but it drastically enhanced the distance that I could retrieve that and that those fish would chase that. So when this is stripped through the water on that floating line setup, it stays within about the top 4 to 5 inches of the water column. So I could work into the deeper bend. As those bigger fish would turn to pursue it, I could continue to retrieve and strip that even through the shallower water. And the majority of takes that I got, those bigger fish were taking that at anywhere from 6 to 12 inches of water. That's where their pursuit led them to. So as you go through the fall, if you're on a piece of water, your stuff's low, but you still want to fish them, you have options. You just have to adjust your setup. You have to look at the water conditions, look at what's going on, and try something out, like a longer leader and an unweighted little streamer. Still allows you to fish streamers, still allows you to target those bigger fish, and it's a lot of fun seeing them come through that skinny water, chasing that down. So as always, if you have any questions, don't hesitate to get a hold of me. Message me on Instagram. You can get me off my website too at www.thinairangler.com. Have a great day.